Hi guys, welcome back to the DxO PhotoLab series. Now today I want to do an end-to-end workflow using one photograph. Now we're not going to use every tool in the box, we're going to use only the tools that we need to bring the values out of this photograph that I shot it with. Now what I mean by this is, when I set up the shoot, there was a certain amount of planning involved, there was a certain type of photograph I was after and a certain effect. And what I found on site caused me to change those ideas a little bit, but I want to bring all of that through into the final edit. Let me tell you about the photograph. It's on the screen behind me. I was with my friends Richard and Kirsten from Spanish Highs, Spain-based mountaineering and adventure group. And what we had decided was to shoot at dawn in the Picos de Europa. Now, the location we'd chosen was spectacular. It was about 800-foot drop into a river gorge, and above us was probably 200 to 300 feet of vertical cliff face. We hiked from the road about a mile and a half in the dark, lit only by moonlight, to get to this location. It was a plateau, and what we were looking at was across the gorge with the cliff face in front of us. Now, we'd figured out that the rising sun would illuminate the spur that was sticking out on our side of the gorge. And to make this shot, what we figured was that the shadows cast by the sun would basically blot out half of the rising cliff face behind. So we would have this very dramatic scenario with the spur lit and just this dark void behind and then the cliff face. When this actually started to happen, we realized that the shadows were coming out in a sort of, not a semicircle, but a gentle curve, and it made the cliff face behind look like a different planet. So quickly, acting on the spur of the moment, we persuaded Kirsten, by dint of the fact that she was wearing the brightest jacket, to go and stand on the spur as close to the edge as she dared to go. Now, Kirsten's an experienced mountaineer, so she went a lot closer to the edge than I would have dared, but be that as it may, we got the shot. We actually took this frame and about five other frames, and this turned out to be the better of the frames. And what I want to do now is to go into processing, and let's take the values that we had for this shot, take the drama, the scale, the tiny little person in a massive great landscape, and bring all those values through into the processing. Let's go and have a look and see how we did that. First thing to do is to select which shot we're going to work on, and for me it's one of the first two that I took. So this one, slightly zoomed in, we've got quite a lot of scale in here. Second one's actually a better exposure, zoomed out a little bit. It's got to be one of these two. It didn't work in landscape mode, and that's a great picture, but it's not going to exemplify the values that I had when I took the picture. So we're not going to be, you know, we'll be making a different picture. This one, Kirsten's not visible in, so that's a non-starter. This one, the shadow has become too advanced and we've lost that lovely curve. This one, again, the curve's gone. So I think it's going to be this one or this one of these first two pictures. This one's better exposed, and I quite like it pulled out because it places that spur into space, as opposed to this one. The spur could be simply running off the plateau, could be any sort of distance. So this one really exemplifies what I was after when we did the shoot. So let's have a look at this one. So first thing we do is check the presets have been applied properly. So optical corrections only. And Let's have a look. The exposure seems okay on this one. We're pretty evenly balanced. We've got more highlights than lowlights, but this is to do with the amount of light tones in the picture. Starting off with the lighting, keep the exposure as is. We turn smart lighting on, we get a very slight uptick in the exposure. I think actually that it looks better with smart lighting on, so we'll keep that. In selective tones, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring out the drama in this shot, so I'm going to make my shadows much deeper. And I'm honestly not concerned about peaking here. What my main intention here is to really make this a dramatic picture. And there's got to be a concept, you know, the idea is that Kirsten is looking into the void here. And we can only really get that if we really decrease these shadows. So that I quite like. I could crush the blacks a little bit more, but I don't really want to, you know, ruin the contrast here. So I think this is fine. Put clear view on, and I'm going to take that down to about 20. That makes a good difference. And let's just add a bit of contrast here. So again, deepening those shadows and just increasing the lights a bit. And that, I think, is fine. I need to bring a bit more warmth into this. This is quite stark. It's not quite monochrome, but it's very stark. And I want it to be a little bit warmer. So we'll go to the HSL color wheel here. And what I'm going to do is to saturate the oranges and yellows to bring out some more color in these rocks. So okay, so we're getting a little bit more warmth coming in here. That's good. And what I want to do, I think, finally, is to use a control point to really bring out Kirsten in the picture. So let's take this up to 100%. Let's find Kirsten. Here she is. We're going to use a control point here to nice and sharp as well. So we go to local adjustments. New control point. In order to do this, what we want to do is to brighten Kirsten up in this picture. If you look at the thumbnail here, it's not immediately obvious. Your eye isn't drawn to her, but she's nice and sharp here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take a local adjustment. We'll put it, and this is the art, is choosing the color exactly. Let's go, we might have to do this a couple of times. We'll go with that. Let's just pull this out that way, a little touch more. Okay, and remember that with the control point, it's going to choose the pixels to change that are directly underneath it. So I'm not worried about what goes on here. So let's just raise this up. Basically, I don't want to overdo it, but let's have a look at that. And now you see on the thumbnail, it's much more obvious to something really bright drawing your eye. But so let's have a look at that in screen fit mode. Okay, that's much better. We'll take a closer look. Okay, I think we can live with this as a little bit of little bit of brightness going on there, but I think we can probably live with that, given that she's so small in the actual photograph. Right, let's review the whole picture now to make sure that everything is as we hoped it would be. I'm going to go back into the color module. Now, the question here is simply, do I want to add a little bit of temperature to this? I think I want it warmer. I think this is good. So there we have it. So what I'm trying to get across here is that this isn't a matter of using every tool in the box. This is definitely less is more, and this is the way that I approach all my editing, is I will look at the picture and I will try to remember what it was about that picture that I wanted to convey, what were the qualities that I really wanted to get across. And in this one, it was all about scale. What I wanted to do was to show just how big the picos can be. When you see them, you know, when you walk around that corner and see these mountains, it's like Game of Thrones. It's incredible. The scale is absolutely immense. And that was really the point that I wanted to make, but I wanted to make it in such a way that it was different. And this, I think, really does play into that. And we've got a person here who is absolutely dwarfed by the scale of the mountains around them. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys, and hopefully we'll see you next week.